like Sam Ferris. Tell me where is sanity? Tax the rich, feed the poor. Tell there are no rich no more.
Hello, if you want to show me who you are, it'd be nice. Daryl and Freedom, thanks for stopping by. If you guys want things to talk about, please put it out there. Otherwise, I'm going my own direction. Hey, Johnny. Rebecca, how you doing? We'll get started in about 15 seconds. Good morning, people. Well, it's 11:30 here, so morning's almost over. It's almost midday. There was a chat going on, and people looked like they wanted another place to go, so I opened up. Let's talk a lot about lack of faith. Well, I like to talk about the negative things in a positive way, okay? There's a lack of faith because there's a lack of understanding. And there's a lack of understanding because of what the churches have done to the Word of God. And to me, the Word of God is, excuse me what I look like, I'm sorry, I didn't plan this. So the Word of God is the only thing that we can bring back to the Father. So it is up to us to learn the word, because once we learn the word, we can do what Archangel Michael did to Satan when they were disputing the body of Moses. He says, the Lord rebukes you. When Jesus was in the 40 days of fasting, what did Jesus say to Satan? You know, he used the scriptures. So the scripture is what we are required to learn, and we bring that back to the Father. It's the only thing that we can take with us, which will make our light better that's inside us, or brighter inside us. As in Revelations 2:28, that says Jesus will give us the morning star. Now that's something very interesting I want to talk about to a lot of people, because what is the morning star? If you go into Isaiah 14:12, I'm just going to double check that. But it says that that in the King James, that Jesus is the bright and morning star in Revelation 22:16. But in Isaiah 14:12, it says that in the King James it's Lucifer, but in all the other alternative Bibles it says morning star, bright morning star. You know, it gives controversy, and these are the things that we are to pick up in scripture. Hey, it's nice to meet everybody. If I miss some things here, then if I miss some people and some things here, then please repeat it, because I close my eyes because it helps me think and flow with my words. So I watch the chat as much as possible, but when I got something on mine, I go. Thank you. 5x5. Okay. Daryl, thank you. I see some pretty good names in there right now. Let's just say hello to them. The Watchman, Curious George, very nice to see you here. Daryl, of course, Calhoun, and Rebecca, glad to see you here. Surrender to Christ. We've gone down to one person. What happened here? We've gone down to one person, and I don't know what's going on. I live in a camper trailer, just to let you know. I had got myself a trailer and a truck, and was going to back and forth across Canada with all my savings, and try to wake up people just before the SARS things happened. And because I went so hard and spent all my money, I live in this trailer, and I love it, and I can move anywhere I want. But now I got to put 8 hours a day of work back in so I can collect some more money. I don't eat much. I don't do much except for scripture. So I don't need much money. But I don't know if you know my story. Back in 2016, it was before that, I was listening to Jonathan Kleck, and I had given my writings that I received from the Lord, and they're in my videos. You can see, as in, they're probably just before the AA20 in the beginning of my videos. One called Sermon on the Web. Whoops, not sure if you remember you from years ago, the Paul Bailey chat beginning, and you can see where things have gone. Yes, I left Paul Bailey. I can't stand him no more. I tried reaching out to him. There's some things in the Bible that these people just totally ignore. But anyways, with Jonathan Kleck, I give him my writings, Sermon on the Web, parts 1, 2, and 3. John 1:1-17, and Genesis 1 and 2, because these, I believe, are the most important information drops of the scriptures. There is some other ones, but these ones I believe are very important to know Jesus. So throughout that, Jonathan Kleck started teaching my stuff in 2016. He totally changed his teachings. Since then, I've been trying to correct Jonathan Kleck as well, because he does the serpent seed doctrine, says that Satan mated with Eve to have Cain. Well, number one, Cain didn't have six fingers and six toes, or they would have said something in scriptures. And number two, Eve is not a daughter of men. And in Genesis 6, it says that the angels had taken the daughters of men and did marry them, to which they choose. So I'm not worried about collecting Kleck. The Lord's using him to deliver the gap theory, okay? And this is what it's all about. Why does everybody ignore Genesis 1-2 and how the water is in the universe before anything happened in the creation story? It's surrounded by the Spirit of God, and it's there, okay? Now, another big clue is, it was Lucifer in heaven, as I say, Isaiah 14:12 says Lucifer fell. It was Lucifer in heaven, but yet Satan in the Garden of Eden. So some time had to have passed. And Jesus said, I knew you before you were in your mother's womb. Yesterday, because your thoughts, church, on off-grid farming with, yeah, you know, I've followed them a little bit too. Yeah, I'm wondering if space is fluid, but if you go into 2 Peter 2, chapter 2 and chapter 3, also in Job and in Jude, it speaks about the water boundaries, and that's the water that's above the firmament. So there's more than just a little bit of a talk here, but one thing that they've done, and you got to see the stand back and look in the forest, because Satan has planned this right from day one when he was talking to Adam and Eve. Okay, so what he's done throughout the time has placed seeds, obviously not on the path, and some of these seeds are the hurdles that we are fighting today in the churches, okay? People that are not even believers in him, just take off the instance Isaiah 45, yeah. I'd have to see what Isaiah 45 is about right now to get it. You should read those verses. What verses? The ones that I'm speaking of? I used to watch Kleck just because I am in a... Yeah, well, you know what? The reason what attracted me to Kleck, he is such a good teacher. You got to give him that. He can deliver like you would not believe, even though it's wrong. And I have a saying that says, when you're confused, point your toes in the direction you want to go. Do not look left or right, and just go. Taking baby steps, okay? This has helped me out quite a bit, especially in times where you think you're gonna crap your pants because something's happening. Yeah, I've been there many of the times, praying, oh Lord, please get me out of this. But Peter's, Jews, waters above, yes, it's all there. And okay, and I'm going to put this out there. After Jonathan received my writings, all of a sudden I was, it was about 6 to 8 months later, I was blocked from my family. And then my son died of stage 4 brain cancer. Okay, now, I've been warned many's a times to stop teaching what I'm teaching. Okay? By my family, by churches. I had stacks of my writings, and then every time I went by a church, I put it in the mailbox. The people that attacked my family and I were my ex's family, because they live in Niagara-on-the-Lake, which is a well-to-do area beside Niagara Falls. This area, well, Gretzky has a winery there, and big number 99, right on the main road and everything. This place is full of money and wine vineyards, and it used to be a fruit belt, but they have changed it over to a wine belt now. It's full of Freemasons. In fact, the church that I brought my kids to, my daughter married one of the pastors. So they have totally turned against me. They stopped me from seeing my children. And the one that was taking care of my children, because I had a breakdown, I can explain in a different time, but I'm on this mission now, so. I had a breakdown, and I asked her to take care of the kids while I was going to try and move up north and get the kids away from my ex, because she was bipolar, and breaking into the house at all times, ramming cops with their car, kicking them in the groins. She was bipolar very bad. The government was taking the children away from her, and I just had taken responsibility of the children. So, through all this, Jonathan Kleck has acknowledged me here and there, but he hypnotized me over the internet to get more information out of me. Yeah, and he literally hypnotized me as I was talking like on a phone call on the computer. He three times that I know of, I was speaking with Jonathan Kleck over the internet. And then two of the times he would ease me into disconnection. Okay, so he would say, just sit back and listen to. He had grabbed some music off my music list of Rush and started playing it. And it's very important, because there's a Rush song that he was playing. He played one note of back when his son was doing the guitar thing. But he played one note of, and I know that song because I play the song on my guitar. And it's one of my favorites. But Jonathan Kleck is a very dangerous person, okay? He put his phone number out on the internet and then blah, blah, blahed over it, but the Lord had given me the number, and I called Jonathan. He hung up on me and then called me back, because he has to have control. If he does not have control, then, Jonathan doesn't want to be there. So that's what happened with the twins. He was trying to take control of the Ark, and the twins, were backed up into a corner and said, get out of here. So, I'm just looking at the Jonah. I'm a terrible reader, and if I say your name wrong, I totally apologize. It's not purpose. Sherry Lay? Joy Trujillo, I know who that is. Daryl, he's popping all over the place. Yeah, but there's Rebecca, who's always Daryl and Rebecca, you guys are a blessing to me, okay, when in the chats. when we see each other. Who else is there? Freedom, 5022. Okay, so we got seven people in there. I haven't seen any of my regulars in there. Yeah, I use emojis because a picture tells a thousand words. And it's a delivery, okay? At the Tower of Babel, when they dispersed all the people amongst the worlds, which is our native Indians, they had to use pictures to speak at first until they built their language. And that's why we got the hieroglyphics all over the place. But yeah, if you look at the art of the native Indian, you'll see it's very close to the Tower of Babel. People condemn me for saying that, but you know, just take a look at it with the Lord says in scriptures. You know, get the answers from the Holy Ghost, not from people. So when you do things like that, you tend to get attacked. So and I will challenge anybody with scripture, okay? If they think they know scripture, I'll challenge them, okay? I may learn stuff, new stuff, because I am always learning new stuff. But unless you have the idea that a third of the angels fell before Genesis 1-2, they were put into Genesis 1-2 as a detention until Jesus entered the darkness, when the darkness comprehended it not, because they did not know the Father's word, because they followed Lucifer, so they did not know the Father's word. And so Jesus went into the water, John 1:1-17, he went into the water to bring the Father's word for salvation. Okay, now when you think of the cross is so important. There's so many stages of the cross. I'm not stages in the walk, I mean stages on what the cross accomplished. First, Jesus had to forgive our sins, that the Father had removed us out of his dimension. Okay, so Jesus took our punishment. Okay, let's go back. When the angels fell, the Father separated them, and the other angels could not talk to these angels, or they would be punished. That's why the water boundaries. That's why the Spirit of God surrounded the waters. And Job 38:30 says that the face of the deep is frozen. Okay, so, and it's also hid by a rock. So the light of whatever is, it's not hitting the water, so it freezes. So when Jesus entered the water, it started the thaw out and opening of the prison. The third of the angels, Jesus took the sins at that time away so that the word would go to these people. Okay, the third of the angels that fell. Meanwhile, Satan was still allowed to go to and fro from the earth, as it says in Job 1 and Job 2, also in Job 8, I believe. Job 6, I believe. So, when Satan was going to and fro from heaven to earth, he was creating chaos. That was the first stage of Satan being removed out of the universe, the heavens, and confined to the earth. There was no more room found in heaven for Satan. Okay, now Satan is the fallen title that Lucifer received, because when you receive a different position from the Lord, you get a new name and a new position. So Satan was allowed to go to and fro from the earth, and then there was no more room found for Satan in heaven. And then Jesus said, I seen Satan fall like lightning. All those three steps happened in his fallen state already. Okay, and when he was confined to the earth, it had to be sometime after the flood. Okay, I believe it was during the resurrection of Jesus Christ, because he defeated death. But somewhere Satan was confined to the earth. Now, that's one thing about the cross. Another thing that I believe about the cross is Jesus' hands were nailed to the cross so his arms would not fall down in war. And there's a parallel to that into the Bible. When I believe it was Moses was battling, or Aaron, I get confused with names, I gotta look it up, I'm just going on the cuff right now because I wasn't ready, but I would have the verses ready normally. But they held his arms up in the battle, and when his arms went down, they were losing the battle. And when they had propped up his arms during the battle, they were winning the battle. So if he had put his arms down, that's why I believe Jesus' arms were nailed to the cross. Now, he said, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." But at this time, the Father had to turn away from Jesus. So when he turned away from Jesus, he did not hear him. He could not help him. So when Jesus said that, he was saying to the people that were there watching, "Bye, Sherry. Sorry you're leaving. I hope everything is good, and may the Lord bless you." So when Jesus said that, he was speaking to the people. Joni, bye, Joni. And I believe that was a direct message to the apostles that ran away in fear. So then the resurrection. I'm sorry, I'm getting caught up in the chat and knocking over everything. The resurrection was for Jesus to leave the Holy Ghost for us to learn. Because Jesus said, "If I do not go, I cannot leave the Holy Ghost or the Comforter. But if I do go, you will do better things than me." Think about that, okay? Because that's very big. How could we do better things than the Father if Jesus is the Father? We couldn't. Another thing that they did, they enforced the Trinity at the First Council of Nicaea, 326 after resurrection, because not one place in the Bible does it say Jesus says, "I am the Father." Okay? There's controversy that people manipulate things when he says, "I and the Father are one," but yet the angels that followed Satan are one in the last days. So why can't Jesus be one with the Father? It's low here. What, the volume? I'm using my iPad right now. Normally I use a different one, but volume, yes. Okay, well, I'll see what I can do. I don't know how to work any of this. My iPad fell or slipped, so I'm wondering if I covered the mic. But no. I'm trying to find out if I have a mic setting that I can change. At least 1 minute of video is needed to start a highlight. Okay, it's fine. Okay, It's Rebecca that said hers was low. Okay, well anyways. So, I forget where I was at. Oh, it's why I have a hard time. I'm not good at these live things and computers and all that. And with ADD, ADHD, your mind wanders quite a bit. But, yes, I live in Niagara Falls. If that's what's... it's a bit muffled. That's probably me. I don't know. Okay. But, I got ADD, ADHD, and all through school I had to have my test read to me, or I couldn't pass them. Yeah, I can't read either, so I had a hard time in school. But when I hit the Bible, okay, I was reading all the other ones, the NIVs and stuff, and I couldn't get delivery from them. So I went to the, 1611 King James. Somebody had given me one, and I opened it up and I started reading, and I could read it like you wouldn't believe. Even the misspellings and everything as we see them today, I could go through them like you wouldn't believe. So I start to span. I like to picture things in my head for memory. I got an audio Bible and started following along. And I pictured the Bible in my head, because as the emojis give you, a picture gives 1,000 words, that picture in my head delivered the Bible to me. And I believe the Holy Ghost did it through that. So then I started going all over YouTube. I started off with Theo McConnell at Able Danger. And I believe that's where I had met Jonathan Kleck, somewhere around there, somewhere in that time. And that was Field McConnell. And it was good, but I don't know if Field was a part of Q or not, being deceived. But, and this is for hiring. Yeah, I lick my lips to get them wet so they don't stick and I talk properly. But he says that I'm a serpent seed because I lick my lips. But anyways, there's many people that attack you when they see the truth in you. That's for sure. But I Kleck. Yeah. You know. I got a thing going on with Rebel. His name's skipping my mind right now. Gene Rebel. There. I don't know why Gene does not engage with me. Everything that he does is a put down towards me, and now he's against the hireling for some reason. I think it's just for attraction, because how many people go visit a fight when it's going on? Yeah, I used to say Rebel, but it was a mistake. It's just my mind and the way it goes. That's how I remembered it, because I don't know if anybody done the program Mega Memory. I tried to do it to help me in my spelling and reading, but it didn't work. But it's a great memory program. And they say, excuse me, hang on a second here. They say to picture things, the funnier they are, the more you're gonna remember them and relate it to names and words, so that you can remember them. Well, that's just too much for my mind to go through, and I can't remember all these things. So I deal with logic, not memory. I forget where I was going with it, Gene Rebel. But anyways, Gene Rebel has something against me. And it all started when I brought up the gap theory to him. He jumped back like I was hot fire. And it's been 3 years now. I've been patiently waiting to engage with him to ask him those simple questions. But now the Lord is working with me, and he's bringing out the answers without me even having to ask him now, because other people have confronted him about his beliefs. So it's very important when you listen to somebody anywhere to understand what he believes, because his delivery of words are going to be in those boundaries if he's a man of God. So that's why it's good to hear the scripture in people's words. My memory is already doing good. Yeah, I remember pain more than anything else. Gene Revel, R-E-V-E-L. The guy's a smart guy, a nice guy, you know, he seems to be a pleasant person, but for some reason, he just will not engage with me in a Christian way. It's always attack, attack, attack. Matter of fact, one of the times when Jonathan hypnotized me, I told him about a story about picture day in school, and I got dressed up, and it was recess time, and the girls had chased me, and they were kissing me, jumping on me and kissing me, taking me to the ground, kissing me and all this stuff. And I went home at lunch, and I was all messed up. My dad asked what happened. I says, the girls, they were chasing me. And he gave me heck and punished me because I didn't keep myself clean for the picture day. And I told Jonathan this story. And Jonathan went on and to use a story similar to this about girls beating him up. He changed it a little with his little way. And there's been a couple stories like this that Jonathan has used. Now, I don't care about what he does to me, because it all comes, my rewards are in heaven, and I know I'm being used. Other things that I will bring out later on, but I am being attacked, yes. I've lost emails, I've lost Facebook pages. I'm surprised nothing has happened to my YouTube channel, but that's another thing. When you go through my YouTube list, look at the ones that are copyrighted, because there's songs and there's pictures in those songs that deliver a mass message along with the song. I go back to them all the time. I think that, I don't know how I did it, but I think that some of them are fantastic. But anyways, because music is another, pictures and music are the two main ways to deliver. Now, when the daughter danced in front of the king, and she asked for John's head on a platter for her reward, I believe those dance, the belly dances and stuff like that, there's messages within those belly dances. The movements of the hands, you know, the movements of the body. They are also seductive, you know, because they're dancing for the king and all that too. So we know what's going on there, orgies and whatever else. But I believe that the dances are set up just like the native dances to tell stories. Jonathan Kleck uses a lot of those hand symbols. Okay, and you see a lot of the hand symbols all through everything, you know, all through the Freemasons and all this. Okay, so there's a lot going on if people really want to pay attention. But remember, the more information you retain through the Holy Ghost is the more you're going to be attacked. And I'm not trying to scare you. All I'm trying to do is tell you the truth. Because we do not fight against flesh and blood. It is spirit. The Father is spirit. Okay? Jesus is now spirit. Something to think about. When Jesus was in the Garden of Eden, talking to Adam and Eve, was he a light being? Was Adam and Eve a light being until they got covered in the skin sin suit? Okay? And then once they were covered in that skin sin suit, they were not able to see Jesus again. No flesh was until he was born in the flesh. Okay, that's, and you know, when they received the skin sin suit, now the light is inside them. Okay, there's so much that the churches will not deliver in scripture. Okay, and how can you tell a liar? It's not about what he says, it's about what he doesn't say. Okay, so if somebody's beating around the bush about something, you got to go back to that bush and take a look at that bush. Then you'll find out what his lie is. But I've gone 42 minutes, people, and it's 8 degrees outside, and it's springtime. I've got some things to do outside. If there's anything that anybody really wants to talk about, please bring it up. This new format makes it impossible to click on and share links. Yeah, I know. It's terrible. I don't understand computers, but if there's three dots on the right-hand side, bottom corner of my computer screen, and when I touch the three dots, it says share. So I'm wondering if that's what you're looking for. Maybe that's just to share that I'm on the internet at this time. I don't know. But I only want to study the scriptures. I don't want to study computers and all this, because I know that's where the elite are trying to bring people. If you've seen the movie Videodrome, and I'm sorry about bringing that one to attention, but Blondie's in it, Debbie Harris, the one that eats the cake bodies made of herself. She did a movie called Videodrome, and I think that's what they're going to be doing to the people, is bringing, because like I said, I was hypnotized over the internet by Jonathan Kleck. He hypnotized me. He didn't get me to do things except for answer questions for him, okay? So I think that's what they're going to do with this technology, and that they're going to hypnotize the people that they can't get away from it. It's already happening with just the technology itself. But they're going to use it with frequencies to get into the mind and hack the mind. Okay, now they've got this thing saying, oh, it's a physical. No, it's not a physical thing. The mark of the beast to me. Long live the new flesh. Okay, thank you. Yeah, well, when I touched the screen, I muted it. Thanks for catching it quickly. How's that? Is that better? 5x5? Yeah, thanks, Daryl. But again, if we look at the life that we live and how it's changed throughout time, you can see the lure into the dark and luring away from the light.
And that should be the biggest, you know, the loudest thing that we should be seeing. They're attacking our children. Why? Because if they get them when they're young, they spread it throughout their life. They will kill off this 3 days of darkness, I think, that's coming, is going to kill off the people that are giving their movement a problem. They're giving their movement hurdles. I think they'll use the 3 days, because there'll be no communication, to send in their people. Yeah, Muslims, the police, whatever it be, government. They're all working in cahoots. They're all antichrist. The police, their badge even has it, Satan all over it, especially with the sheriffs with the stars. And that's another thing. The star symbol. The star symbol is so big now, okay? One of my videos, I've gone through a whole bunch of star symbols and stuff like that, of different cults and stuff. But there's one about the pyramid up, right side up, the pyramid upside down. And it's within itself. It's not above and below. It's actually morphed in itself. And I believe it's the symbol for the Silver Gateway Masonic teachings with jinns. And it's a writing, I don't know where the heck I got it from. It just showed up on my table one day, and I read it, and man, it's exactly what's going on about you know, everything in the world with the elite. They say the silver road, the silver roadway, but it's a silver gateway. And they're using, I call it sleight of hand with the words and the technology, and they turn things so that we do not get a proper delivery of what they're doing or saying. And I think this is a pattern that the world is accepting nowadays, because back in the days, if you did anything against the word, you would be stoned or, you know, dealt with quite swiftly. Now they're protecting it all. So it just shows you what time we're in. They're ignoring anything that the people are saying and want through the government, and they're doing pretty well the opposite. Trump, you know what? I believe Trump took over Epstein's business. And another thing is, I believe Trump's wife was one of Epstein's girls before she got married, and she was also a Victoria's Secret nude model as well. Yeah, and I've got proof of this. Epstein than anybody else, okay, wearing different clothes, different times. I've got Epstein's girlfriend, whatever her name is, I forget. I've got pictures of her with Elon Musk and, you know, all these people that they're trying to promote today in the media, saying, oh, these are good people, these are good people, these are good, bull crap, okay. Well, I don't think Trump works for Obama, okay? I think they're in the same boat, yes, okay? Especially when Trump said to Hillary Clinton, if I was president, you'd be in jail, okay? He was president. Did he go to jail? You know, they do exactly opposite to what...
Oops, shouldn't slap the table, Mike, come on.
Oh, I'm having a good time with the computer today. But anyways, yeah, this is 50 minutes going on. I didn't plan this. I got some things to do, people. I've got to go to the bathroom and stuff too, so I'm kind of bouncing around. I'm gonna plan a live. Well, it's Monday night, and I got to work tomorrow, so, and that work gets in the way. Yeah. but I want to know if my notices go out when I do my notices. So next time I do a live, if you people pick up on my notice, let me know if it worked or not. I'm just learning all this stuff. I don't like computers. I do not like computers more than spelling, and I can't spell properly. So, Lord, thank you for delivery today. Thank you for the people that come in today. There's been some new people, which is another avenue for your to spread your word, which is the glory that I like to do for the Father, give gratitude to the Father. Thank you, Lord, for all the wisdom that you've given to everybody that have brought together in your word for you, and especially the way that people communicate on the internet in your positive way. I give thanks for all the people that are protecting the children and doing whatever they can. Thank you, Lord. There's nothing else to say except for thank you. In Jesus' name, I do pray. Okay, good night, people, or good day, people, and go out and enjoy the sun. Get some vitamin C and vitamin D in ya. We need it. God bless. Amen. Thank you, Daryl. Thank you, Rebecca. I really appreciate it, what you do. Okay? God bless you.